Well, 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 y'all glad to be in God's house? I'm a minute ahead. It's not 11:02 yet. Ain't God good? You know what? Where would we be without Him? Where would we be without Him? Because He does so much for us, even when we don't even realize it. He's still looking out for us. Amen. I am happy to be in God's house. I can't hardly breathe. My voice is a little raspy. I may sound like I come from the mountains before I get done preaching today. That's all good too. Amen. Brent Jones, will you pray? Amen. Let's all stand and sing, please.
Why you ever chose me has always been a mystery. All my life I've been told I belong at the end of the line with all the other not quite. We'll all never get it right. But it turns out they're the ones you were looking for all this time. Cause I'm just a nobody trying to tell everybody all about somebody who saved my soul. Ever since you rescued me, you gave my heart a song to sing. I'm living for the world to see. Nobody but Jesus. I'm living for the world to see. Nobody but Jesus. When Moses had stage fright and David brought a rock to a sword fight, you picked 12 outsiders nobody would have chosen, and you changed the world. Well, the moral of the story is everybody's got a purpose. So when I hear that devil start talking to me, saying, who do you think you are? I say, I'm just a nobody trying to tell everybody all about somebody who saved my soul. Ever since you rescued me, you gave my heart a song to sing. I'm living for the world to see. Nobody but Jesus. I'm living for the world to see. Nobody but Jesus.
So let me go down, down, down in history as another blood-bought faithful member of the family. And if they all forget my name, well, that's fine with me. I'm living for the world to see. Nobody but Jesus. Let me go down, down, down in history.
Go down in history.
As another blood-bought, faithful member of the family.
That's all I ever wanna be.
And if they all forget my name, well, that's fine with me. I'm living for the world to see.
Nobody but Jesus.
Cause I'm just a nobody. I'm trying to tell you. All about somebody who saved my soul. Ever since you rescued me, you gave my heart a song to sing. I'm living for the world to see. Nobody but Jesus. I'm living for the world to see. Nobody but Jesus. I'm living for the world to see. Nobody but Jesus.
Amen. You can be seated. Somebody give us a word of testimony. Go right ahead. Vicki James would be proud. It's almost like you took a Vicki James class. No, my stuff went out. Go right ahead. Attached to an old body. You're giving him fresh oxygen this morning, though, ain't you, Brother Bob? There you go. Good deal. Anybody else?
Woke up.
We missed that one last week. I had to interject it in there for you, Stuart.
My back's doing better. I'm moving. I got out of them a little more yesterday, and I didn't die.
But... Baby steps. Yeah.
Still can't get in touch with the doctor, but at least I'm on the road to getting both.
There you go. Anybody else?
Liz got okay for a house. So she's in the process. It's been a long time though.
Where is it at? In Raisville?
Yes, on
you'll have to get a passport to get out of Bethany. Anybody else? Well, as y'all can see, Miss Vicky's out with her mom. So if y'all don't mind, if we can just get a couple of ushers to come, we'll take up our tithes and offering. Broke back. Brother Brandon, pray.
Heavenly Father, thank you this day, Lord, and watch over us and caring for us, meals, Lord. And thank you for just looking out for everybody, Lord, the church family that we have, Lord. And just thank you for everything you do for all of us. Thank you for giving us a good pastor and a nice church to be in, Lord, and just to worship you. Lord, take this offering and bless it, Lord, and use it as you see fit. Bless those that can give and those that can't, and those that are here and those that are not. Lord Jesus, thank you for everything you do.
Amen.
Some glad morning when this life is over, I'll fly away to a home on God's celestial shore. I'll fly away.
Jackson, to get the blood pumping. Well, let me get back over here because I can't see what y'all see. It's announcement time and the church calendar. Watch, I might have to walk over here and read it with you. Now I come back. God's blessing me. He don't want me to have to walk. And come on in the back. All right, movie night and a cookout this Saturday. Somebody look up sunset. Right fast. And that'll determine what time we start. How about that? I'm trying to work here so the movie's outside, but, you know, I have a bedtime. Yeah.
It's supposed to be raining.
We don't prepare for rain. We prepare for the sun to set. We have accommodations if it rains.
Don't be around 7:20.
Well, that'll work. All right, let's do this then. Let's eat at 6. I'll try to have food ready before that, so we'll be ready to eat at 6. May not need a thing. unless somebody wants to bring a dessert, but not all everybody.
You don't make things like chili buns?
No, because I don't think it's going to be hamburgers. If that changes in the next day or two, I'll let you know. But I'm thinking about cooking some potatoes and chicken. I think I can get 40 leg quarters and a pan of potatoes on my grill at one whack. So that should be enough. And that way I can get over here to take, I'd have to start about 3:30. I can make that work. It takes a minute to cook all that. We got to do something. And following movie night, we'll restart our Wednesday night services, first Wednesday night in October on the 4th. And it's going to tie in, I think, with the movie we got planned for Saturday. And then we got a pretty good chunk of candy over there. I don't really know how much more we'll need, but we may need a little. If you want to bring a small bag of something, the little ones, don't bring the big candy, the little candies. That'd be great. Trunk or treat on Halloween. We're having a work day on November the 4th. Veterans Day celebration on the 12th. Homecoming on the 19th. I don't know, we'll figure that out. It shouldn't take us about an hour to clean up outside and dust off on the inside. So we'll figure that out. Anything else? Did I miss anything? Oh, I did. And I'm gonna have to look up a date. I wanna say it's the 17th. We're going to have our Christmas program on the 17th of December, that afternoon. We'll figure out a time for that. Lots of singing. We may do a little something afterwards. We'll figure it out, but let's pencil that date in. Amen? Anything else? Ain't got no more time. It's all filled up. But y'all plan on coming on out Saturday, come ready to eat and kick back. Like I said, if we can have it outside, we'll have it outside. I'll try to get the screen set up and let it de-wrinkle this week. I'm going to put it in my shop. It gets hot enough in there to cook. All righty. Prayer time. We don't have any bulletins. Vicky's got a whole lot going on with Miss Helen right now. So y'all, first and foremost, let's remember her. I told her not to worry about a bulletin at all. So we'll make do. Amen. But y'all remember her, lift her up. I went by there and visited with them Thursday, I guess. And her mama is very, very, very weak. Very weak. So the good thing is she knows where she's going. May not be ready to go right now, but she knows where she's going. So, but y'all remember Vicky and Helen. Amanda's got a cousin and lives in St. Louis. They are traveling to New Mexico to pick up his daughter and bring her home. So y'all remember them as they travel. I didn't think it was that far, but it's a pretty good way. So y'all remember them. Anybody else? Yes, ma'am. Due to the liver. She's got a lot of things going on, so please Anybody else? All right. Anybody else?
Carson Hayes, he's a son of the neighboring department. Two families. He was in the hospital this week. He was diagnosed with RSV, rhinovirus, and pneumonia. He's 3, I think. He did get to come home yesterday, but he does have a long road ahead of him.
Anybody else?
The Paschal family is also their mom, Geneva Paschal, passed away this week.
Anybody else? Well, let's go to the Lord in prayer. Father, we come to you today, God, just so thankful that you've allowed us to come into your house, Father, with the sole purpose to worship you. And we don't want to do anything else. We just want to come in here and join together and just worship you, Father. That's where we want to be. We want to worship you. And God, we're thankful today, God, for everything you have done for us this week. We're thankful, God, for everything that you're going to do with us this coming week, God. We just appreciate all that you do, and we're thankful for that. God, by way of special request today, God, we got Janet Harmon, Jerry White in the hospital, God. We don't know exactly what all is going on, Father, but you do. That's all that matters. That's all that matters, Father. And you know what to do, when to do it, and how to do it, God. And we just ask you, Lord, to touch them. God, for Miss Vicky and Helen, your children, God, protect them. God, keep them strong, keep their strength up. God, I know Miss Helen's home going may not be long, God, and you know where she's going, and you're ready to accept her, God, but I'm not so sure that Vicky and Gary are ready for her to go, God, so they're going to need strength. They're going to need your strength. We just trust you. Give it to them. God, protect Alan and Leslie as they travel first from St. Louis to New Mexico and then back. God, we just ask you, Lord, to put a hedge of protection around the cars as they convoy back, Father. God, Carson Hayes, a 3-year-old, RSV, coronavirus, pneumonia. Father, you are the great physician. We have to hang our hat right there and put our hope and our trust in you, God, that you'll bring this little one through, God. We have no doubt. No doubt. Alden Bailey waiting on a liver transplant. God, got all other issues propping up. God, we just ask, Lord, that you just touch the body, God. Touch them, heal them. Make them well. Whether that be supernaturally or whether that be through the hospital and the doctors and surgeons, it makes no difference, God. It makes no difference. God, the Paschal family lost a loved one. Not easy, never easy. And God, we just ask, Lord, that you touch them, give them strength, God, and give them a surety that they can overcome it. Father, for the rest of the service today, God, we ask, Lord, that you touch us. Bless this church, bless this family. God, bless the preacher today. Father, we love you. We thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. All righty. Let's sing along with somebody. I don't know who's playing. What Kind of Man? What a great song.
I am Barabbas, a rebel, a prisoner. Death was the sentence for me. Led before Pilate, I stood there beside him, this man some were calling a king. And as the crowd shouted, "Crucify him," the soldiers let me go free.
What kind of man, guilty of nothing, would suffer the shame and disgrace? Hang on a cross, despised and rejected, and willing to die in my place. At Calvary,
for someone like me, someone like me.
My name is Thomas. For 3 years I followed. I saw every wonder and sign. They say he has risen, that his grave is empty, but I just can't believe he's alive. Now standing before me, Jesus shows me the scars in his hands and his side.
What kind of man embraces a doubter, lovingly drawing me near? I don't have to wonder if I've been accepted. He settled the worry and fear at Calvary for someone like me.
My name is Peter. I knew him and loved him, but oh, how I failed him that night. I promised Jesus that I'd never leave him. I'd willingly lay down my life. But there at his trial, I stood by the fire. I denied him three times.
What kind of man
kind of man bleeds for the worthless and saves him whatever it takes?
What kind of man would rescue the sinner and offer amazing grace at Calvary? At Calvary for someone.
Put that together and figured, and then they found out that's what I was having for lunch. God be the glory. I like manhood. That song said, what kind of man would lay down his life? Think about that. The Bible said he could have called 10,000 angels, could have brought a legion. He stayed on the cross by his choice. not the Romans. Pilate couldn't do nothing. He did it on his own. So I began to think about stuff. I began to think about what kind of man does it take to live this Christian life as we know it. What kind of man can live this life? What all do we have to do? So we're going to go through a little bit of 2 Corinthians chapter 4. We're going to read 10, 11 verses, and then we're going to go from there. If you got your Bibles, turn to 2 Corinthians 4, verse number 7. We're going to read through 18. But we have this treasure in the earthen vessels, that the excellency of the power may be of God and not of us. We're troubled on every side, yet not distressed. We are perplexed, not in despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Cast down, but not destroyed. Always bearing about in the body the dying of the Lord Jesus, that the life also of Jesus might be made manifest in our body. For we which live are always delivered unto death for Jesus' sake, that the life also of Jesus might be made manifest in our mortal flesh. So then, death worketh in us, but life in you. We have in the same spirit of faith, according as it is written, I believe, and therefore I have spoken. We also believe, and therefore speak, knowing that he which raised up the Lord Jesus shall raise us up also by Jesus, and shall present us with you. For all things are for your sakes, that the abundant grace might be through the thanksgiving of many redound to the Lord, to the glory of God. For which cause we faint not, but through our outward man perish, yet the inward man is renewed day by day. For our light affliction, which is but for a moment, worketh for us a far more exceeding and eternal weight of glory. While we look not at the things which are seen, but at the things which are not seen. For the things which are seen are temporal, but the things which are not seen are eternal. Stephen, will you pray? Amen. So, we start off, go back to the title, bud. Which man? Well, before we can figure out which man, we got to figure out what it takes to be a man. What it takes to be that man, right? We're going to go back to verse 7. It says, but we have, I thought it was dark in here. He said, let there be light, and there be light. Didn't try to read in the dark. He said, but we have this treasure in earthen vessels, that the excellency of the power may be of God and not of us. So the first thing we got to do is we've got to figure out what is a vessel. What's the vessel? What's the earthen vessel that they're talking about? Us. It is us. He said, we have this treasure. What's the treasure? The treasure is God. And the treasure is God's power. But you can't just put God in any kind of vessel. You understand what I'm saying? First thing we got to do, we got to prepare the vessel. We got to inspect it. That's the first thing we got to do, that vessel. We have got to inspect it. What are we looking for? Is it clean? Has it got any cracks in it? Will it hold what you're trying to put in it? Can you share from it? We got, where is it at? Look, let me get this bottle over here. We got this bottle, and I ain't uncorking it for no amount of money. But we got this bottle left over from the Primitive Baptist Church. This bottle contains something. Is it anything that we want or need? But if it was full of, well, if it's full of water, I might well try it. But we could take the top off. The vessel's good. The vessel's clean. The vessel holds the product. The vessel has a top on it. And I can unscrew the top and I can share from the vessel. Right? What we got a lot of times is we got a vessel. The vessel has not been prepared properly. The vessel's not been inspected. The vessel's not acceptable for the product that you're trying to put in it. You understand what I'm saying? We can't pour a holy God into a vessel that is filthy and dirty, and it may want it to stay that way. If God goes in, the mess is going to come out. God's going to clean it up. He's going to tidy it up. But what we do is we keep trying to pour the dirt and the filth and the trouble and the mess in there with it. Bible says dirty, sweet water and bitter water can't come from the same brook. Right? That's straight out of the book. We got to clean it up. We got to clean up the vessel. The biggest thing with our vessel is, can we pour from it? What good is all the power that God has to give if I keep it here? Huh? Is it any good? No. It's meant to be shared. It's meant to be distributed. It's meant for us to pour it out wherever we go. Your vessel has to be prepared, and it has to be built in such a way that you can pour out everywhere. We're the earthen vessel. The vessel that we have here, it's not perfect. The vessel we have here, it's not going to stay perfect. But the vessel I'm going to get is going to be perfect. So right now my thing is, I have to prepare the vessel. How do I do that? How you prepare? Well, rule number one, you have got to be the type of vessel that God can pour into. See, that where the mess is in that bottle right yonder. If I was to take a top off of it and set it outside, eventually the bottle would be dry. Not prepared right, not proper. It's not the right application for that. So what we got is we got to be the vessel. We've prepared the vessel. We've checked it. We've inspected it. It's holy enough for God. And then God is the one that's got to do the filling. God's the one filling us up. He's the one that goes around making sure that we can handle it. And He puts enough in us. And then what's in our vessel is a whole lot more important than the vessel. Y'all understand? I can share Gary all I want. Gary's not going to get you to heaven. Gary can point you in the right way. Gary can't take you there. I can't drag you along. If you're not saved, guess what? You will die and you will split hell wide open. Known fact. Ain't no need to sugarcoat it. Too much of that in the world today. Let me get on my high horse for just a minute. I seen a thing on Facebook with a lady asking for recommendations for a church in the county to go to that doesn't offer a political climate, understood, or change. If you get in that blessed book, you will change. If you can come through the doors here week in and week out and not change, we're in the wrong place. We have got to change. We have got to change how we do things. We have got to change, and the change has got to be from the inside out. Too many places we want to sugarcoat what's on the outside, and what's on the inside matters. If you're looking for a church where there's no change, where you can come in and go out just like you came in, don't come here. I'm going to tell you right now, I don't want that. Don't come here. If you don't want to come in here and draw closer to God, don't come. That's the only reason we are here, to see the saved of Christ grow closer to Him, and the ones that don't know Him begin to know Him. To repent means to what? You're going in that direction, and you turn and go in that direction. If you repent, if you get saved and you repent, there will be change. So we prepared our vessel. We got to fill our vessel. What's in your vessel? What's in your vessel? It can't be just anything. That stuff right yonder ain't meant to be shared. It may have been at one time, but it ain't going to be shared around here. We got to get stuff in our vessel that we can share all over this county, all over this city, all over this state. That's the stuff we got to get in that vessel. Is your vessel this important? This important. Is your vessel full to overflowing? It ain't just for you. It's not just for you. The vessel is God's. The vessel is the what God give us. The vessel is what God's filling up. God is not going to top you off and screw the cap on. It's not going to happen. He ain't going to top you off, put you in the thing on the stove, and give you a water bath. Not going to happen. God don't mean for you to be canned. God means for you to be running over. God wants you to pour out everywhere. But that's what we got. We got a bunch of people running around, and the vessel seemingly full, looks full on the outside. Look, if y'all see my truck go down the road, not my diesel, my company truck, two things is fixing to happen. Either I'm fixing to stop and get gas, or the gas light's already on. Okay? If I'm riding down the road, you can't tell the difference. Stephen knows me and knows that I'm going to ride it sometimes a little past when I should, and then I'm going to call somebody to come bring me some gas. It's just a known fact. And it's terrible because somebody else is paying for it, and I'm still too sorry to go fill it up. But when it goes down the road, you can't tell the difference. Looks full. Rides like it's full. I was on the phone with him one day when I run out. Right on side of 40. I said, hang on, let me call you back. I believe I just run out of gas. Right on side of 40 ago. Looks full. It looks good. But what's on the inside? There was nothing. That's what's wrong with a lot of churches today. That's what's wrong with a lot of people today. The fact of the matter is, you can't tell from the outside. God said they're in an earthen vessel. That's what Paul's talking about. We're in an earthen vessel. You can't tell. But the good stuff's inside. The good stuff that's on the inside has got to come out. If it don't come out, it is of no good to God or you. At all. Not a chance. It's got to come out. What's in you? So you're full. You're overflowing. Is it worth sharing? Think about that. Depends on what you're full of. You following with me? Depending on what you're full of. You might be full of stuff that don't nobody else in this world need. You might not be full of the right stuff. You may not be. What may have happened is, instead of God filling you up, maybe you filled you up. Maybe you filled you up. And if you filled you up, I don't want none of that. I don't want it. I want what God has given us, and I want all the power that God has given us, and I want to be powerful enough that others will see the light of the Word of God in this world today. So we got, is it worth sharing? So all of that stuff in you, all that stuff in you, if we go back to verse number, let me get it right here. 16. The title of this message was Which Man? For which cause we faint not. He's talking about all the troubles and trials and tribulations. But though our outward man, your outward man's going to perish. The Bible says it. The outward man is going to die away. But he said, even though our outward man will perish, yet the inward man is renewed, what did he say? Day by day. Day by day. So that man that we feed, and see, we got our vessel. Vessel's us. The vessel is us. We prepared our vessel, I hope, because we didn't prepare it. The rest of it's null and void. So we prepared our vessel. God's filling. He's pouring into a prepared vessel. He's poured into the correct vessel, and he's pouring the right amount. The question is, if the vessel's not prepared, if the vessel's not correct, and God's not filling it up, but you're full, who filled it up? Which man are we feeding? Which man are we feeding? Y'all know I didn't grow no garden this year because last year I got tired of the weeds and the clover and the, I don't know. It was a mess. I just let it grow up. I just weed eat the other day. See, what I fed was not the plants that were to grow. I fed something else. All the junk grew up. All the stuff grew up. All that mess grew up. See, what you feed, listen to me, what you feed will grow. Sometimes it'll grow out of control. Then what you do? You go back to bed, you got to start back over. You got to prepare the vessel. And you got to check the vessel. And then you got to let God pour into the vessel. God will pour the weed killer in there, trust me. And he might have some of that stuff mixed up like what's on the back of my four-wheeler. When it comes out, it goes brown. Quick. Whatever that jug said, I think I dumped three of them in that 15-gallon thing and filled it up. It'll kill it off. When God begins to work in your life, it'll kill off all the mess. It'll kill off all the junk that goes on. And what you'll have God feeding the inward man instead of you feeding the outward man. That's our problem. We feed the outward man. We shine him up. We make him look good. And we look at me, look at me, look at me, instead of look in me, look in me, look in me. You understand? What people need to see is not what's out here. It's what's in there. What God's filled into you, which that man you're feeding, is that man you're feeding, is he life-changing? Is he life-changing? Well, whose life? Well, first of all, your life got to change. Your life's got to change. You can't feed nobody else and get their lives changed unless your life's changed. So you got to feed, you got to let God feed that inward man and that outward man to get in line. If that inward man's getting fed and that inward man has changed your life, then the outward man will change. The outward man will change others' life because of the inward man. Do you understand what I'm saying? Does what's being fed, does it change those around you? Does it change those around you? Or is everything just running along status quo? As the old man said, it's all chicken but the bill, right? And the bill's still chicken. Is our life affecting those around us in a positive way? Are we making an impact for God in the circles we run in? Or are you making an impact for God on a daily basis? Are we changing lives? If not, we ain't doing it right. We're not doing it right. So we got to change lives and we got to affect them. So I got a few questions. Which man going to get us to heaven? Which man's going to get us to heaven? The outward man, inward man? The inward man. Which man's going to get others to heaven? Outward man, inward man? Inward man. Which man's the most important? The inward man. The inward man. What's on the outside don't matter. If it did, I'd be 6'5 and have a head of hair, but I ain't got neither one. It's okay. It's what's in here. It's what's in here. And knowing that a holy God has took up residence in here. That's all that matters. That's all that matters. So that man will get us to heaven, that inward man. That inward man will get others to heaven. That inward man is the most important man. Verse 18, bud. While we look not at the things which are seen, Bible tells us we got to live by faith, right? Got to live by faith. But at the things which are not seen, for the things which are seen are temporal, the things of this world, they're going away. This outward man is going away. But the things which are not seen are eternal. They're eternal. So, let me say this. Everybody in this room is going to live somewhere forever. Eternal is eternal. Eternal is eternal. You're either going to live in heaven or you're going to live in hell. Point blank. It's A or B. There's no C, multiple choice, and just run down through that checking them. It's A or B. You're either going to live in heaven or you're going to live in hell. That's your options. He just said right there, they're eternal. I got some, give me John. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that heareth my word believeth on him that sent me. We're going to stop right there. Who's talking? Jesus. He said, I say unto you, he that heareth my word, maybe that's the reason that folks don't, easy, bro. Maybe that's the reason that folks don't become as holy as they can become is because they don't hear his word. If Jesus was right here telling it, would it be different? Think about that. If Jesus was right here telling it, it'd be different. I'm reading his word. What's the difference? He's following with me. But Jesus being here be different. And believeth on him that sent me. God has what? Everlasting life. Do you see the difference? Everybody's going to have eternal life. Everybody's going to live forever somewhere. What we got to figure out is the where. You're going to have to figure out what your zip code's going to be. I don't want eternal life. I want everlasting life. I want to be able to worship Jesus. I want to be able to catch a fish in the river of life. I want to be able to sit down and sup with the Lamb. Do you understand what I'm saying? I want to look at the nail scars in his hands. He said, have everlasting life and shall not come into condemnation, but is passed from death unto life. Paul said that to be absent from the body is to be what? Present with the Lord. But it ain't no cooling off period in that thing. You ain't got no buyback program. When you die, it's one or the other. Choose wisely. Just like that. We have to have accepted Christ as our Savior, and to do that, like my little soapbox ran a minute ago, there will be change. There has to be change. I'm going to read some verses out of the next chapter. For we know, this is in chapter 5, 1, for we know that if our earthly house, this body of this tabernacle, were dissolved, we have a building of God, and house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. For in this we groan, earnestly desire to be clothed upon with our house which is from heaven. If so be that being clothed, we shall not be found naked. If God has engulfed you, if God has taken over every aspect of your life, when people look at me, they don't see Gary, they see God. Skipping down to verse 6, therefore we're always confident, knowing that whilst we are at home in the body, we're absent from the Lord. For we walk by faith, not by sight. We are confident, I say, and willing rather to be absent from the body and to be present with the Lord. Wherefore we labor that whether present or absent, we may be accepted of Him. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, that everyone may receive the things done in his body according to that he hath done, whether it be good or bad. I want everlasting life. I don't want nothing else. I don't want to be no middle of the road Christian. I know I look good on the outside, but I want to look better on the inside. I want to be that guy. I want to have the glow of God and His glory around me, and I don't want people to hesitate. I want them to know that I'm one of God's children. Today, if you don't know Christ as your Savior, but you're guessing on a multiple choice test, you're guessing, hoping you pass. When you got the cheat sheet, check the box. It is honestly that easy. Check the box. Oh, but I got to give up this and that. Trust me, you will. You'll give up this and that. Why? Because God will fill you to overflowing. See, if we get our life in order, if we get our place in God's kingdom in order, then what we do is we affect all of those around us. And we got to work on that. We've got to affect change in this kingdom and around this country. And look, let's don't aim small, lose small. All right, let's go big or go broke. We can change the world, and we can start it right here. Amen. Look, let's stand. If you don't know Christ as your Savior, if you do not know beyond a shadow of a doubt, because the Bible says we can have a no-so salvation, not a hope-so salvation. It tells us that. If you don't know you're saved, check the right box. Let's get it today. Don't let it go no farther. Check it today. If you are saved, but you're trying to mix a little bit of muddy water in with the clean water of God, it's not going to work. It's not going to work. It's not going to work. Got to get God and give Him the vessel. Let God clean it out and pray to God to keep it that way, to keep it under control, and to keep it under wraps. But I beg you, if you don't know Him as your Savior today, let today be that day. Let's sing.
dozen times. Know your name, I know you don't know mine. But I won't hold that against you. You come here every Friday night. I take your order and try to be polite. Hide what I've been going through with you. Look me right in the eye. Would you see the pain deep inside? Would you take the time? Tell me what I need to hear. Tell me that I'm not forgotten. Show me there's a God who can be more than all I've ever wanted. 'Cause right now I need a little hope. I need to know that I'm not alone. Maybe God is calling you tonight to tell me something that might. At your church, for all these years you've listened to my word. You think I know all the answers, but I've got doubts and questions too. Behind this smile, I'm really just like you, afraid and tired. Just like everyone, Jesus, I need you, I need your love to save my life.
Nothing apart from salvation. Not a thing in the world. We don't have nothing. You can gain all the riches down here that you want. Without God, you got nothing. Without salvation, you got nothing. You can't buy your way in. You can't purchase a ticket. You can get one for free, though. Please don't let today go by if you're not saved. Amen.
Amen.
All righty. Well, we will see y'all Saturday afternoon. I'm ready to eat. We'll have a little time of fun and fellowship. Kim, you want to dismiss us?
Thank you.
Amen.